It's news time. Information is power. Be current. The news headline. How I was arrested because I requested for weapons to fight Boko Haram. Ex-soldier narrates. A former Nigerian soldier, Temple Awunaya, has narrated his experience at the war front in the battle against Boko Haram terrorists. During his interview with Punch, Awunaya claims he was arrested for requesting for better weapons to fight. He has since narrated his audio. You may recall that security agencies in the country have been at war with the members of the terrorist group responsible for attacks on various parts of the country. Boko Haram is one of the deadly terrorist groups terrorizing areas in the northern part of Nigeria and neighboring countries. The war against the group has been ongoing for years, and people who took part in it have since shared their audio. Speaking during his interview with Punch, Awunaya said, "I was enlisted on the 28th of August 2012, and I passed out from training on the 17th of December. After training, I was posted to Niger State. And a few months later, I was fully inducted into the theater to counter the Boko Haram terrorists. In the course of my career, I was deployed to Dambua local government, and I witnessed the first attack on that area. We managed to overpower the Boko Haram terrorists during the attack, despite the quality of weapons. I then later approached my loving commander and complained that my weapon kept jamming during my battle. My commander advised me to service my rifle every morning, but I explained to him that I was already doing so." Narrating further, Awunaya added, "I realized during my first battle in Sambisa Forest that Boko Haram had more sophisticated weapons. I discovered that during our gun battle, that the terrorist group had a new machine gun and an anti-craft air gun. My troop lacked such weapons. What my troop held was MPMG machine gun. I approached my commander again to complain about the lack of medical professionals or medical kits on the battlefront. As we advanced to Bali, more soldiers started complaining. I recall that my commander told me that the issue of weapon has been a significant challenge in the battle against terrorist group. We lost a lot of brave men in battle." Narrating his arrest, Awunaya said, "On the 9th of July 2014, my troop was instructed to advance to Tambwa. After our deployment, I noticed we were traveling with soft-skinned vehicles. I was demoralized as I saw no BMG nor anti-aircraft machine guns. We were ambushed during our journey, and 9 soldiers died on the spot, while 23 others sustained bullet injuries. We did not travel in bulletproof vehicle. We buried in dead officers after the incident, and injured officers were admitted to the hospital. 2 weeks later, we were instructed again to deploy to the same Dambua local government area. We waited for the arrival of weapons, but all we received was an armored paraffinal carrier, which was old. No weapon came. We were eventually accused of refusing to obey orders and arrested by military police officers. We were eventually locked in an underground cell for a year. I was only able to peep to see the sky as it gave me hope." This was an interview from one Awunaya, who was at the time a soldier before being, you know, removed from, like, being sacked from being part of the Nigerian soldier. And he was narrating his experience. The ex-soldier therefore complains about how he was, you know, at the war front in the battle against the Boko Haram terrorists. And then he had an interview with Punch where Awunaya claims that he was arrested just for requesting better weapons to fight the Boko Haram. We know that the Boko Haram a member of the terrorist group, and they have a whole lot of sophisticated weapons. And truly, if one is to defeat them, especially our Nigerian army, who has been guided, you know, by constitution to do that for us, if they are to win this kind of battle, Definitely, they have to do that with more sophisticated weapon than these people. Else, they are prone to die. And just like we have received a whole lot of information about our Nigerian army being ambushed several times, and now the Boko Haram members, even apart from their own, weapons, still survives on stolen weapons from the Nigerian army. And this has led to the deaths of many of our Nigerian army, especially the very brave ones. And here is Aunaya recalling how the security agencies, that is the Nigerian army, were killed because of lack of good sophisticated weapons. He said he was actually, enlisted into the Nigerian army on 28th of August 2012 when he joined them. And as well, he passed out of training on the 17th of December. And after training, he was posted to Niger State. And after a few months, he was actually added to the theater to counter the Boko Haram terrorists. And his first battle with the Boko Haram, it was when he was deployed to Dambwa local government. And they managed to overpower the Boko Haram terrorists during the attack. But despite the quality of weapons, because he complained seriously that the quality of weapon during the battle was very bad, his own particular gun kept jamming during the battle. However, that of the Boko Haram members were, very okay, and it was supporting their fight and saying that he had to explain this to his loving commander in his words, and he complained that his weapon kept jamming during the, first battle that he experienced at Dambwa local government with the Boko Haram. And then he said that after explaining to him that what he said was that this has been the major issue of the Nigerian army in terms of having, good weapons to fight. He said that the Boko Haram members had more sophisticated weapon, and they even have a new machine gun and an anti-craft air gun, but his troop lacks all these weapons. That at the point again, he had to complain to the commander about professionals, like medical professionals and medical kits on the battlefront to treat those who get injured along ways. But what the commander just kept on saying the same thing, and they asked them to go back to Dambwa local government after the attack on them, and they lost a whole lot of people. And then during their deployment, the vehicle that they gave to them was soft skin. It was not bulletproof. And because of this, the Boko Haram members still, ambushed them during their journey. And they lost, 9 soldiers and died on that spot, while 23 soldiers sustained bullet injuries because they did not travel in bullet vehicles. And after that, not too long, about 2 weeks later, they were still instructed to go back to that same Dambwa local government. And they waited for arrival of weapons, but they did not receive any, weapons, and they only received just an armored personnel carrier, which was old, and no weapon was there. So they were accused of not, obeying orders to go back to Dambwa local government, and since then they were locked down in an underground cell for a year before he was released, and he could not see the sky unless he peeped through, and that gave him hope. And this is the pathetic story of Awunaya Temple. Thanks for listening.